Hello friends, welcome to 2Thepoint. In this session, we are discussing about time and work. This is the last part of time and work we are about to discuss. A, B and C can do a piece of work in 20, 24 and 15 days respectively. They work alternately. First day C, second day B and third day A. In how many days work will be completed? It is given that A completes a work in 20 days and B does it in 24 days and C does it in 15 days. So we know how to find out the total work, that is nothing but LCM of all these three, that is 120 units. Now find one day work of A, B and C, that is nothing but A will do 6 units of work and B does 5 units of work and C does 8 units of work. So altogether A plus B plus C, they do 19 units of work. In the question it is mentioned that they work alternately, so all these three won't work together. So 3 days work of A, B and C together is 19 units for 3 days. Now we have to find in how many days the work will be completed. So that is nothing but total work by 19 units for 3 days. 19 into 120 which is equals to 19 6 are 114, remainder is 6. That is 6 part of work is being left out. So they are not working all together, they are working in an alternate days. So 6 into 3 which is equals to 18 days. They work for 18 days in alternate days. And next, at first C will work and the second day B will work and the third day A will work. So 18th day A will work. So the next day, that is on 19th day, C will be working. So C does 8 units of work. So 6 by 8. Cancel it. 2 3s are 6. 2 4s are 8. So that is nothing but 18 and this 3 by 4 days. So altogether A, B and C work on alternate days for 18 3 by 4 days to complete the work of 120 units. A contractor employed 50 men to complete the project in 100 days, but later on he realized that just after 25 days only 20% of the work has been completed. How many extra days than the scheduled time are required? It is given that 20% of work is done in 25 days. So how many days it requires to complete 100% of work? Just cross multiply this. Take the other side as x. 20 into x is equals to 25 into 100. X is equals to 25 into 100 by 20. Therefore, x is equals to 125 days. This is the total number of days required to complete 100% of work. So what they have asked here, how many extra days than the scheduled time are required? So the scheduled time is only 100 days. So these people are taking 125 days to work. So subtract it, you get 25 days. So 25 days extra is needed to complete the work. 36 workmen are employed to finish a certain work in 48 days. But it is found that in 24 days only 2/5 work is done. How many more men should be employed to finish the work in time? To solve this problem, you have to learn one formula, that is nothing but M1 into D1 into H1 by W1, which is equals to M2 into D2 into H2 divided by W2. Here, M1 and M2 represent workman, D1 and D2 represent total days taken by them to complete the work, and H1 and H2 represent how many hours they are working, and W1 and W2 represent what is the total work done by them. So if you see here, M1 is equals to 36 workmen are employed, so M1 is 36. To finish a certain work in 48 days, they are telling the work should be completed in 48 days, but these 36 men are not working for 48 days. It is found that in 24 days, only 2/5 work is done. These 36 men, for 24 days, they are completing only 2/5 of the work. How many more men shall be employed to finish the work in time? So, men. How many more men? That is, you have to include extra men. 36 plus X. And D2. The time given is 48 days. Out of that, 24 days is completed. So, remaining 24 days are left out. And work done. 2/5 of the work is done. So, remaining 3/5 of the work is left out. So, now we have to solve for X. So, that will be the answer. Substituting these values in the formula, we get 36 into 24. We don't have hour, so no need to worry about it. Days and hours are alternate. If one is present, the other will not be there. In some cases, both days and hour is given. So, next, work is 2/5, which is equals to 36 plus X M2 into D2 is 24, whole divided by remaining work is 3/5. Simplify the equation and solve for X. We get 108 is equals to 72 plus 2X. Therefore, X is equals to 18. So, 18 men should be employed to finish the work in time. 90 men are engaged to do a piece of work in 40 days. But it is found that in 25 days, 2/3 work is completed. How many men should allow to go off so that the work may be finished in time? So, we can use the same formula, that is nothing but M1 into D1 by W1, which is equals to M2 into D2 by W2. Here we can see that M1 is equals to 90 and D1 is equals to 25 and W1 is equals to 2/3. Next, M2. It is given that men should allowed to go off so that men, we are removing some men from the work. That represents 90 minus X because the persons are decreasing. And D2. Out of 40 days, 25 days of work is being completed. So, remaining 15 days are there. And work remaining, 1/3 of work is remaining. Now, substitute these values in the formula. We get 90 into 25 by 2/3, which is equals to 90 minus X into 15 by 1/3. Now, simplify the equation and solve for X. We get 150 is equals to 180 minus 2X and 2X is equals to 30, where X is equals to 15. Therefore, 15 men should be removed from the work. It is given that 16 men working 18 hours a day can build a wall of dimension 36 meter into 4 meter into 24 meter in 20 days. How many more men will be required to build a wall of dimension 64 meter into 6 meter into 18 meter working 12 hours a day in 16 days? As usual, use the formula method to solve the problem. Here we have men and the hours worked, days as well as work done. So, there are total of 16 men working for 8 hours and the work is to build a wall of 36 into 4 into 24 meter and number of days 20. And M2 is equals to, they have asked how many more men will be required. That is, you have to take X plus 16 and hours, they are working for 12 hours and days, they are working for 16 days and the work done by them is 64 into 6 into 18 meters of building a wall. Write this all in the formula. I'm writing it directly. 16 into 18 into 20 divided by 36 into 4 into 24, which is equals to X plus 16 into 12 into 16 divided by 64 into 6 into 18. The work given, don't try to multiply it because it gets complicated. As far as possible, try to keep the data same. And now simplify the equation and solve for X. We get 180 is equals to 48 plus 3X and 3X is equals to 132 and X is equals to 44. So, 44 more men are required to build a wall. Jaya can do a piece of work in 3 days while Manoj can do it in 4 days. The wage for full work is Rs. 350. If they both work together to complete the work, then find the earnings of Jaya and Manoj. So here, Jaya is working for 3 days and Manoj is working for 4 days. The total work is 12 units. 1 day work done by Jaya is nothing but 4 units, and 1 day work done by Manoj is nothing but 3 units per day. Now write the efficiencies of both Jaya and Manoj in ratio form. That is equals to J is to M is nothing but 4 is to 3. So efficiency of Jaya is 4 and Manoj is 3. So total of 4 plus 3 is nothing but 7. So for this 7 parts, 350 rupees is being distributed. For how many times 7 divides 350? 7 5s are 35. So it is 50 times. So next, for 4 and 3. If 7 is being multiplied 50 times, we get 350. If 4 multiplied by 50 and 3 multiplied by 50 gives you 200 and 150 rupees. The sum of this should be equal to 350. So the sum is equal to 350. So Jaya gets 200 rupees and Manoj gets 150 rupees. A, B and C together earn 300 per day, while A and C together earn 188 and B and C together earn 152 rupees. What is the daily earnings of C? It is given that A, B and C together earn 300 rupees per day, whereas A and C earn 188 rupees per day and B and C earn 152 rupees per day. We have to find the daily earnings of C. So take the equation A plus B plus C, 300 per day, and A plus C, 188. Subtract A plus C from A plus B plus C. We get A gets cancelled, C2 gets cancelled. We are left out with B, and 300 minus 188 is nothing but 112. So 112 rupees is the daily earnings of B. Now we have to find out for A. A plus B plus C is equals to 300. Take the other equation, that is nothing but B plus C, which is equals to 150. Subtract this, B minus B 0, C minus C 0, and A is equals to 148. So A earns 148 rupees per day. Now substitute the values of A and B in the first equation, that is A plus B plus C is equals to 300. A is 148 plus B is 112 plus C is equal to 300. Now find the value of C. That is nothing but 148 plus 112 is 260 plus C, which is equals to 300. Take 260 to the other side, we get C is equals to 300 minus 260 and C is equals to 40. So C earns 40 rupees per day. With this example, we have learned entire problems on time and work. See you in next session with one more interesting topic. Thank you.